So we calculated power of the first bit, that is the power of this one, and next one is we need to calculate coefficient of fluctuation of the speed. So to calculate the coefficient of fluctuation of speed, first we need to know fluctuation of energy, because fluctuation of energy is given in terms of the fluctuation of coefficient of fluctuation of speed. So we will see how to derive that one. This is the second bit. So delta E equal to I omega square and CS. For a given I and omega, we need to calculate CS. So in the problem, they have given m equal to 500 kg and radius of gyration k equal to 750 mm. So how to calculate delta E? So this is the given torque function. So let's draw turning momentum diagram. This is the turning momentum diagram, and this is the mean torque line. This is the torque axis, and this is the theta axis, and this is the mean torque line. So for example, here if I put 0 in place of theta, if theta equal to 0, what is the value of torque? T equal to 5000. And if I put to 90 degrees or 45 degrees, before that I will go to 45 degrees, then T equal to 8000. And if theta equal to 90 degrees, T equal to 9000, and if theta equal to 180 degrees, what happens? T equal to, this becomes 0 and this becomes 1, so again it becomes 500. So this is the 0 and this is the 45 and this is the 90 degrees and this is 135 degrees and this is 180 degrees, and this line TM equal to 7000. This is the 7000, and let's draw this one. So at 0 degrees, this is the 7000, so this is the 5001. And at 45 degrees, T is 800, so more than this. So for example, this is the one at 45 degrees, and at 90 degrees, this is the 9000, so it is further more than this at 90 degrees. And in the same way, at 135 degrees, this is again 800. So this is again like this, and at 180 degrees, it's becoming again 500. This is the 5000. So again here, this is the 5000. So let's draw the curve now passing through these points. So this is the cycle, and the curve is passing like this. This is the given torque curve, and this is the mean torque. So here we can know, now we can calculate easily what could be the, this is the deficit area, this is deficit area, maybe I will write with the red color. This is the deficit area, and this is the surplus area, and again this is the deficit area, and here I have bigger surplus area, the bigger surplus area and a smaller deficit area. So automatically I can say that the maximum area is corresponding to the delta E. So we need to find out area of this green area, the area which is above on the T mean. This is the surplus area. So we need to find area from, let's say it is a point A and this is a point B. So I need to find out the area, this area. So how to find out this area? To find out this area, we need to integrate the T into delta T from point A to point B. So how to find out point A and point B? So here this point, at point A and point B, T is equal to the T mean. So at points A comma B, what is becoming, T is equal to the T mean. So here we will write that one. So what is T? 7000 plus 1000 sine 2 theta minus 2000 cos 2 theta equal to T mean, that is a 7000 that we have already discussed in the first bit. So this and this will get cancelled, and here it becomes tan 2 theta. This is a sine 2 theta and this is a cos 2 theta. So we can multiply this one. You take this whole term into this right hand side, and then it becomes tan 2 theta equal to 2. So theta, this means theta 2 theta equal to 63.44 degrees or 180 plus 63.44, that is or 180 plus. For tan we know that 63, if one angle is theta, another angle is 180 plus theta. So here one angle is 63.44, so another angle is 180 plus theta, that is 243.44 degrees. That is 2.44 degrees. That means theta A equal to 31.72 degrees, comma theta B equal to 121.72 degrees. So we finally achieved values for the theta A and theta B. So now we want to integrate the given this torque from theta A to theta B. So if you simply integrate this T curve from A to B, that will give area under this curve. So that includes all this area, even this area includes, but what we need is only green area. So what to do? So we integrating T from A to B, and at the same time we need to subtract the area formed by TM between A and B. So that can be delta E equal to, so theta A to theta B T d theta, that gives whole area including this green color and blue color. This also it gives, but we need to subtract the blue color, that is T mean into angle delta, angle theta, angle theta A minus theta B. So this theta A and theta B, instead we can write as a delta. This can be written as a, this can, this can be written as a delta theta. So can we combine these two terms? This is the theta A, theta B, T minus Tm delta T. So that is integral theta A to theta B 1000 sine 2 theta minus 2000 cos 2 theta d theta. So if you integrate this, it becomes we integrate and substitute the value theta A and theta B, then we will get the value 2236. This is the delta E, that is the fluctuation of energy that is in the joule. And from here we can calculate so we know delta E and we know omega, that is a mean angular velocity, and we also know I, so we can calculate CS. So now CS can be calculated as a CS equal to delta E by I omega square, that equal to delta E is 2236 by I equal to m into k square. K is the radius of gyration, so m is 500, this is mentioned in the problem, and k is 750 mm. So 500 into 0.75 whole square, this is given in mm. So when again I'm emphasizing that we need to write this in the meters, into omega, that is 2 into pi into 300 by 60 whole square. So this gives 0.8%. This is the value. So what we have done, so we know this formula, but we need to find out delta E. So to find out the delta E, we have drawn torque diagram, turning moment diagram. So we have drawn turning moment diagram, and after drawing this turning moment diagram and the mean torque, we know that the area which is varying around the turning moment, that means deficit and surplus area, so whichever is the maximum one, that would be the delta E. So how to find out delta E? So we need to find out this area, that is from A to B, and the remaining procedure is we have already explained that one. To recollect from the previous sessions, we have already discussed this, how to calculate maximum acceleration. So in this particular case, this is the Tm, and if the vehicle is moving with the Tm, then acceleration angular acceleration is zero. But when the engine produces the torque more than the required mean torque, then the vehicle will accelerate. That means when the crankshaft is rotating from A to above this point up to 90 degrees, then vehicle is accelerating. In this area, vehicle is accelerating, and when the crankshaft is rotating from 90 to again B point, then it's a decelerating. So we need to find out an acceleration point. So to find out this acceleration, we need to write what is the, with which torque is now accelerating torque. We need to know what is the accelerating torque, that is the acceleration torque, T equal to T minus Tm. If T is moving with Tm, then there is no acceleration torque, and angular acceleration becomes zero. But here T is moving with a maximum, engine is producing more T than the required Tm, so that's why it's producing some acceleration torque. So So this would be equal to I into alpha. We need to find out alpha, and before finding out alpha, we need to find out this one. And this T is the acceleration torque, and for the maximum acceleration, this TE should be maximum. So what is the TE? TE equal to 1000 sine 2 theta minus 2000 cos 2 theta. For maximum TE, differentiation should be equal to the 0. So if you differentiate this one, it becomes cos 2 theta into 1000 here plus sine 2 theta into 2000. So again, we'll get cos 2 theta plus 2 sine theta, and that can be written as tan 2 theta equal to minus 0.5. And if you write the values, then it will give two values, that is the theta 1 equal to 76.72 degrees and theta 2 equal to 166.72 degrees. And at which value is producing this maximum torque, that how can we see that? So we can see that by double differentiating this one. So we got this value by doing dou TE by dou theta. In the same way, if we want to find out for the which value of theta this function is, or this TE is maximum, so we again do dou square TE by dou theta square, and this will give 4 into 1000 into minus sine 2 theta plus cos 2 theta. By differentiating two times, here we get 2 also. So at theta 1, what is this value? At theta 1, this value, let's say this is the something capital E, this value is at theta 1 minus 1.34, that is approximately, so that is less than 0. And at theta 2, this value is approximately 1.34, so that is greater than 0. So that means this function TE is maximum at angle theta 1. So we need to take theta 1, consider theta 1 to calculate the maximum acceleration of the speed. So now we substitute value theta 1 in the TE function. So at theta 2, TE equal to 2236.05 newton meter. So alpha equal to TE by I, that equal to 2236.05 divided by mass into radius calculation, that is 500 into 0.75 whole square, then we get 7.95. what is our unit of this one? Radian per second square. So this is how we calculated this one. And for example, if he is asking retardation, instead of maximum acceleration, if he is asking maximum retardation, then we need to calculate TE such that it should become minimum value, or maximum value in the negative direction. So here, fortunately, this retardation is maximum for the value corresponding to the theta 2, and it's giving the same value here for this one. And here instead of 7.95 we will get minus 7.95. so that is how we need to calculate maximum acceleration or retardation. And in the previous bit, calculate point A and B, we equated t equal to t mean. T mean, why? Because here t mean is constant, but instead if t mean is also changing, or resisting torque TS equal is also is not constant, but in terms is in the function of a sine or cos. For example, if it is a 7000 plus something, 7000 plus something like 1000 cos 2 theta, then in that case what will happen? T equal to TS again, T equal to TS again, and we find out the angle set point A and point B, same procedure. But in first, let's read the question. So during its 3/4 revolutions, the load torque increases uniformly from 10 kN to the 15 km, and thereafter it remains constant for half revolution, and then decreases uniformly to in the 3/4 revolution to 50, it's not 50, it's a 5 kN. After this, for one revolution it remains constant. Thus this cycle is repeated. So here what we can write is, we will write torque versus number of revolutions. For example, here torque, so revolutions, so it is mentioned that torque is changing from 10 to, torque in this is a kilo newton meter, so torque is changing from 10 to 15 for the revolution of 0 to here quarter revolution. For a revolution we have 360 degrees. What is the quarter? That is a 3/4. So this is equivalent to 0 to 270 degrees, and from 270 degrees, and thereafter remains constant for half the revolution, that is 180. So from 270 to under 180 degrees, so that is 450 degrees, this torque is remains constant, that is at 15 kN. And after that it decreases uniformly in the 3/4 revolution. So again it's a 3/4 revolution, that means from 450 degrees to, we need to add 270 degrees to this one. That if you add 270, that becomes 720 degrees. So it is decreasing from 15 to 5, and after this one revolution it remains constant. One revolution means that is a 360 degrees. So 720 degrees to, if you add 360 degrees to this one, this become 1080 degrees. So during this period torque is 5, so it's a remains constant. So let's draw the diagram now. This is a turning moment diagram, this is theta and this is a t. So let's say this is 0, this is a pi by 2, this is pi, and I will mark only the important points. This is 270 degrees, that is a 3 pi by 2, and then again I will mark 5 pi by 2, that is a 450 degrees. 5 pi by 2, that is 450 degrees, and then 4 pi, that is 720 degrees. This is 4 pi, and then again I will mention 6 pi. So that means this whole cycle is completing or repeating itself after 6 pi radians. So on this axis, this is the 5 kilonewton meter, this is in kilonewton meter. This is the 5, this is the 10, and this is the 15, and this is the 10. And if I mention or if I mark this one as a A, we have point to another point here to B. That means 5 from, we have point at A 10, that is at 10. And during the first first process, this is going from 10 to 15. So this is going from here to here, and then from this when the crankshaft is rotating from 3 pi by 2 to 5 pi by 2, this remains constant, torque is remains constant. And when crankshaft is rotating from 5 pi by 2 to 4 pi, this again decreasing from 15 to 5. This is the 5, it decreases like this. Actually these are all straight lines. So again during the last revolution from 4 pi to 6 pi, it remains constant at 5. This is the cycle, and I mark this one as a A, and this is the B, and this is C, D, and then E. So this is the turning moment diagram. Here, what is the first bit? Magnitude of mean torque of the motor. We need to find out mean torque. How to find out this curve? Area under T theta curve gives the energy. So E equal to T mean into period, this is the 6 pi, equal to area under this curve, that is the integral. Actually that is integral T into D theta, but here we can calculate this area. So how to calculate this area? For example, this is the A dash and this is the D dash. So area under this curve is area of this rectangle, and then area of this triangle, and then area of this rectangle, and area of this triangle, and then area of this triangle. So what is the area of this triangle? Let's say this is the one. So here area of the first triangle, that is 10 into 3 pi by 2. So that is 10 into 3 pi by 2, that is 15 pi, plus what is the area of this triangle? 2, half into base into height. Height is 5, 10 to 15, that is the 5. What is the base? That is 0 to 3 pi by 2, that means it's a 3 pi by 2. So area of that one is 5 in half into 5 into 3 pi by 2, so that is 15 pi by 4. And then area of this this rectangle 3 is 5 pi by 2 minus 3 pi by 2, that is 2 pi by 2, that means it's a pi. Pi into height 15, so this is a 15. And area of this rectangle, so this height is 5, and this length is 6 pi minus 5 pi by 2, that means how much? That is 7 pi by 2 into 5, and then this is the fifth one, the area of the triangle, that equal to half into base DD dash into height to CD dash. Height is 10 and the base is 4 pi minus 5 pi by 2, that is 8 pi by 2 minus 5 pi by 2, so that's a 3 pi by 2. So 3 pi by 2 into half into 10, so that is 15 pi by 2. So what is this area, total area? So this total area equal to 58.75 pi, but this in term equal to the TM into 6 pi, so that T mean equal to, what is the value, 9.792 Newton meter. So this is how we calculated this mean torque. And now power of the motor. So what is the power of the motor? Power P equal to T mean into omega. So 9.792 into, what is the omega? This is a running motor, is running at a speed of 300 rpm, so 2 pi into 300 by 60, that gives power equal to 307.62 watts. So we calculated first two bits and now let's go for third bit. We got T mean as a 9.792, so we can approximate that as a 10. That is 10 kilo Newton meters. So when you approximate this to 10, so this is the T mean. So here a speed fluctuation of the, in the third bit we need to find out speed fluctuation of the system, that we can calculate by knowing the delta E, as we already discussed in the previous one. CS, we need to find out CS for the given all other terms, but delta E should be calculated from the diagram. So here this is the mean one, and again this green one is the surplus, and this is the deficit. For example, if I draw that one as a black dots, this is the deficit one. So this is the surplus and this is the deficit one, and by little observation this area is more than this one. So this is the required delta E area that we need to find out up to this point. So let's say this point has a F and this is the F dash. So we need to find out area of this green color area. This green color area that is equivalent to the delta E. So how to find out this area? So for example, here we know height of this triangle, but base is not known. So we will take the triangles. Here we will take triangles C, F, F dash and D, D dash, C. In these two triangles, so can we can we write f, these two triangles are similar. So when the two triangles are similar, we can write f dash by d d dash equal to c f dash by c d dash. Here this is the d dash and this is the f dash. This is the f dash. So but we already know c d dash is the 15 minus 5, that is the 10, and d dash also now, that is a 4 pi minus 5 pi by 3, that means it's a 3 pi by 2. So and we know c f dash also, so from this we can calculate f dash equal to d dash is 4 pi minus 5 pi by 2, that is 3 pi by 2 into cf dash. This is the cf dash, so the cf dash equal to 15 minus 10, that is 5, by c d dash, that is 15 minus 5, that is a 10. So it becomes 3 pi by 4. Now we can calculate area of this one. For example, if it is a 1, what is the area? So delta e equal to first area of this triangle, that is off into base f dash into height to c f dash. So off into 3 pi by 4 into 5, that means 15 pi by 4 plus area of this triangle, sorry, area of this rectangle, that is 2. So this is again 5 into 5 pi by 2 minus 3 pi by 2, that is 2 pi by 2 pi. So 5 pi, this is 5 pi plus area of this triangle, that is half into AA dash into BA dash. So AA dash equal is 3 pi by 2 and BA dash is 5. So it becomes 15 by 4. 15 pi by 4. And this is equivalent to the 95 pi by 8. So from this one we can calculate CS equal to delta E, that is 95 pi by 8 into I is given as a mass moment of inertia. This is not by, this is a kg meter square. So that is 2200 into omega square, that is 2 pi into 300 by 60 whole square. So we get CS equal to 1.718 into 10 power minus 3. This is the CS. So if you observe here, see, this is a percentage. So if you observe here, the CS is very much less, very very less. So this is because I is very large. I is in the denominator. So with a bigger I, we are getting a speed fluctuation. This indicates the how much amount of speed is fluctuating. So if you use very very big, very very bigger moment of inertia for the flywheel, obviously it reduces the fluid fluctuation. So that's why this speed fluctuation is very very small. But if you use very smaller flywheel, then it automatically reduces the speed fluctuation. For example, in the above formula, this formula, if I take I equal to 22 and substitute in that one, then we will get CS equal to 0.172%. So there is a drastic change in this speed fluctuation. So if you reduce the I, then it's a increasing. So whenever we need a application where the speed fluctuation should be less, then we go for flywheel with higher moment of inertia.